Hello everybody and welcome. I'm English Ambassador and today I feel like a little rant about what happened this weekend. Basically, this weekend was the France-England match in the Six Nations rugby tournament and there was a lot at stake as France were going for the Grand Slam, which is beating all of the other five nations in the Six Nations tournament. In other words, if you're too stupid to realise what I've just said, they've got to beat everyone and it's called the Grand Slam because they've won all their matches. So, anyway, in case you didn't know, I'm English and I live in France. So you can imagine the tension of me having to show my face in school knowing that I'm the only one that's English and that everybody else is French. Why the hell, England, did you lose? Why did you lose? And it was so close, like 10 for England, 12 for France. Anyway, it wasn't too bad, as on Friday, I got all the stuff like, yeah, we're gonna kick your asses, you're gonna cry, you're gonna go running home to your mummy because we're gonna kick your ass, this and that, kick your ass this, we're gonna win that. You get the picture, and they was gonna like, just completely thrash us, something like 50-2 or something. That's not possible in rugby, but never mind, you get the picture, okay? You get the picture. So I got all this on Friday, and then after the match, because I got a ticket. Wait, I've got my ticket. There's my ticket, look. France, Angleterre. Now, if you don't speak French, that's France, and in French, France is France, and that's Angleterre, which is England. So there's my ticket for the match, and I got that ticket for the match to watch England lose. But we got so close, and it was a good match, because for once, England played some decent rugby against the French, and the French played crap against England, which happens every single time there's a match between these two countries. Because what happens is the French go into the match thinking, oh well, England's playing like shit, we're gonna kick their asses. They're overconfident, they get on the field, realise that, oh wait a minute, they're doing quite well here, and then they think, oh shit, and they start getting nervous, and then they play even more like shit than they was to start with. Whereas England think, it's France! We've got to beat France! We can't lose against France! It's just not possible! So, they go into the match thinking, mwah! 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 We're gonna win this goddamn match! And that's often what happens, except for this time we was playing so shit in all the other matches, we didn't quite manage to pick ourselves up to score one last transformation or whatever to get us 1 point ahead. That's all we needed, one drop goal. Johnny wasn't playing. Why didn't they pick Johnny? He would have got drop goals and all that shit. Please! Why didn't they pick Johnny? But anyway, they can't complain about me too much for one simple reason. When England win, the French always, always say, yeah, you won, but you only scored penalties, drop goals, and shit like that. That's what they always say to me. But wait a minute. In that match, they say, I think I was watching the right match, you know, I think. But this time, France scored a drop goal and three penalties. Which means they're a bunch of hypocrites. I can't stand hypocrites. Can't people just stick to the same story the whole time? They can't do that. They're a bunch of hypocrites. They say, yeah. So I said to them, oh yeah, but this time we're the ones that scored the try and you're the ones that scored the penalties and the drop goals. And they go, oh yeah, but the result was there. That's what I've been trying to tell you every time England wins. It doesn't matter how you win, as long as you win. I would settle for 3-0. That's one penalty, basically, if you don't know what the clue what rugby is, especially if you're American. It's like a better version of football, right? Not soccer, football in American terms, which is American football, which is basically rugby with extra protection because you're a bunch of wusses. That's right, no protection in rugby. Anyway, I like rugby a lot for one reason, right? Because the mentality of the people watching rugby is completely different. When you go to a rugby match, everyone, all the different supporters, like France and England, right? They're all in the, everywhere's mixed together, okay? But if you go to see a football match, that's soccer. Football, soccer, go to see a soccer match, everyone is all like, separated, like all the different things, because if not, they're gonna punch each other in the face. Now, you don't get that in rugby, because for one simple reason, there's a saying that goes, rugby is a sport for, wait, what is it? Rugby is a sport for thugs played by gentlemen, but football is a sport for gentlemen played by thugs. And that's basically what it is, because when you think about it, right, when you think about it, when they interview a football player, basically they go, yeah, well, at the end of the day, we played pretty well, and at the end of the day, we scored a few tries, and we did really try, and their defence was pretty good, but at the end of the day, we came out top. Everything's at the bloody end of the day. I woke up at the end of the day. You didn't wake up at the end of the day. Stop saying at the end of the day. The match may have taken place at the end of the day, but you don't have to say that it took place at the end of the day at the every sentence. Okay, now I'm getting carried away. Basically, I've been a bit stressed lately because yesterday I spent all day writing goddamn motivation letters for the schools I've got to go to next year. And they give you a tiny space like that. You're supposed to write 3,000 characters, right? About 3,000 characters, which is typed out, it's about that much on a piece of paper, and I've got to squeeze it in, handwrite it, into a tiny little space like that. Tell me, how is that humanly possible? But I managed it, because I am not human. No, well, basically, I had to copy this thing out like 5,000 times, and I'm bored of writing, my wrist hurts, and my voice is broken for shouting at England to come on! And that's gonna be about it for me, because I'm getting really carried away here, and basically, I'm sorry, right? I'm sorry if I haven't posted a new video in 3 weeks, and that's because I've been rather occupied with a certain somebody who knows who he or she is. So, say thank you to them, to him or her, for the reason I haven't posted any videos. So, that's about it from me. Post a comment, rate, subscribe, and all that shit, and tell me to your friend, and all that shit that I have to say at the end of my video, just for pure protocol reasons. Goodbye.